பாசத்துக்காக ரொம்ப நன்றி. நன்றிப்பா. தவறிய ஆத்துக்குட்டியா ஆயிருந்தாலும் தேதி வந்து அன்பு காட்டுங்க. எப்பவும் உங்களை பிரியாம சேர்ந்துருக்கணும். என் செல்ல இதையும் உங்களுக்கு தான்ப்பா. ஐ லவ் யூ சோ மச்.
look here. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Welcome you to this very beautiful day. I think it's one of the most precious days for your children when they're going to receive Jesus himself. Most of us maybe don't understand this mystery, because the way you're sitting in church before Mass, it's clear that we really don't feel Jesus is here. But doesn't matter. Jesus loves us above our limitations. So let us all be seated now. I'd like you to sit down. Just relax. A lot of tension. Bringing the children early in the morning. Today all are present in time. Except a few were present, not present for the photograph. All the children sit straight. Just relax. Let us ask Jesus to come here in a big way. As I play this song for you, those of you who know this song can sing along, but others can just relax and ask Jesus to come with us, to be here. So we are here this morning as a very beautiful occasion to enjoy God's love, God's precious love. So let us feel God's presence now. The key is there. All of you just close your eyes for a moment. Even the parents, just relax, take a deep breath. Just say, Jesus, come, fill this place. Holy Spirit, come, fill this place. God, our loving Father, be present here. Give us your Son. We need your Son. We need you in a very big way today, because without you, life has no meaning. So come, Jesus, come into all of us, but come in a special way into these small children who want to receive you today. And help us to understand that your love, your peace, your joy, your forgiveness, Jesus, to give us his peace. Just relax. Pray for peace. Pray for joy. Thank you. give unto you.
Thank you.
Let us pray. For God, in this wonderful sacrament elected as a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruit of your redemption, who live and reign well without end. Try to St. Paul already that time, soon after the death of Jesus, speaks about the importance of the Eucharist. Try to listen carefully. It is as important as the consecration of the host. As Catholics, it is bring about this change, listening to the Word of God. Let's listen carefully to the Word of God.
"This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way he took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Whoever therefore eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be answerable for the body and blood of the Lord. Examine yourself, and only then eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For all who eat and drink without discerning the body, eat and drink judgment against themselves. For this reason, many of you are weak and ill, and some have died." The word of the Lord. Please stand for the gospel acclamation.
So they said to him, "What sign are you going to give us then, so that we may see it and believe you? What work are you performing?" "Our ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, as it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat." Then Jesus said to them, "Very truly, I tell you, it was not Moses who gave you the bread from heaven, but it is my Father who gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." They said to him, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty." The Gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Six charts: Monica, Sheldon, Bensley, Charlotte Maria, Jesslyn Antoinette Fonseca, Lourdes Jennifer, Jocelyn Diana DeMonte, Joshua Ignatius. Okay, come. Those of you who are here, you come. Some of you will be receiving communion later. Good, well done. I hope. See these charts, all the children have to make a chart, you will see them on the sides also, and so that they give their own contribution. Okay? I'm going to ask you some questions. If you answer, you'll get a prize. So what is the last verse of St. Matthew's Gospel? which chapter, which verse? I spoke to you about this in class. Last line of St. Matthew's Gospel. Ayayo. You're putting me in a bad. No? Okay. What's the last line? Any parents know? Matthew. Last line of St. Matthew. Chapter, I'll give you the chapter. Chapter 28, verse 25. Verse 20, okay? The last line of St. Matthew, 28:20. So all are equally bad. Good. Give her a big hand. Okay. I hope teachers didn't tell you, no? Prompted or you said on your own? Anyhow. The last verse of the Bible of St. Matthew, chapter 28, verse 20 is very important. I will be with you till the end of time. I will not leave you. I will be with you till the end of time, till the ages end. That's why we have the Eucharist. I will be with you forever. I won't leave you. Jesus told his apostles, I won't leave you orphans. I will be with you. Any one of you can tell me, what is the Holy Communion? What is the Eucharist in simple words? Okay, come. Come here. Fast, let's run.
Eating the body and drinking the blood of Jesus under the form of bread and wine is called the Holy Eucharist.
Very good. Give him a hand. Come. So eating the body and blood of Christ. They may not have fully understood this. You have not understood. What's the difference between the cross and Jesus in the Eucharist? Okay, good, we tried. Good, well done, sit down. What's the difference? Any parents know? What's the difference between the cross and the Eucharist? Bread, eh? Okay. Okay, she's trying to say something nice. Both are interconnected, that's not my question. But she's trying to answer well, so you get a gift, come. I told them during class, the Holy Eucharist was instituted in two places. One is the Last Supper, the other is Jesus on the cross. Two places of institution, the starting of the Holy Eucharist. Jesus died on which day? Good Friday, very good. Which day? Good Friday. Was it Bad Friday? Jesus died, it should be a Bad Friday, no? Was it bad or good? Why it's good? Good. Because he died for us out of love, it is Good Friday. Though he died, it is good. He broke his body. He broke his body on the cross. Broke. Before breaking his body on the cross, he breaks bread. And he says, I can't be with you always. I'm going to die once and for all. But I'm going to give you my body sacramentally. So he takes bread, beautiful words. Who knows the words of Jesus which happened in the Last Supper?
Before Jesus could betray, he took the bread and gave thanks to the Father, saying to his disciples, this is my body which will be given up for you for the forgiveness of sins. In the same way he took the cup also after supper, saying, take this cup and drink it. It is the new covenant of my blood which will be given up for you.
Very good. Fantastic. You are a big hand. Very good. If you already got the prize, you don't get a second prize. Okay? So So she said perfectly, Jesus took the bread. Next, gave thanks. That's why the Eucharist, Mass is called Thanksgiving. The Greek word is Eucharisteia. It is Thanksgiving. I thank God. We come here to thank God, not to take photos. We come here to thank God. That's the first thing. Jesus took the bread, blessed, looked up to heaven. My Father, I thank you. He's going to die, but he's thanking God. That's why it's Good Friday. He's happy he's dying for us. So that with that, there is no more bloodshed, no more violence, no more killing of goats, nothing. Only the precious body and blood of Jesus, always offered for our sins. Okay? Then the next word is, he broke it. Just as Jesus broke his body on the cross, he wants us to break our lives for the others. And then he took his body, bread, he said, take and eat. If you want to live a good Christian life, these words are enough. You don't need any other words. He looked up, thanked, praised, took the body, broke it. You are the father of a family. You break your body for the family, not for yourself. A mother breaks a body for the family. From the Eucharist, everything is derived. Family life, community. So that's why this is a sacrament. The cross is not a sacrament, it's a symbol. But the host becomes the real body of Christ. The cross is not the real body of Christ, it's a symbol. It is a symbol. It's not the body of Christ. But what you're going to receive very soon, it is the real body of Christ. Real body. You imagine this cross being alive. That body is given to us, alive. So it's a real life-giving body of Jesus. It's a life-giving body of Jesus. So Jesus comes into each one of you now. There's a story told of a little girl, something like you. Little girl who was helping the sister in the sacristy before Mass, you know. Some of the churches, the sisters arranged things for Mass. And she was arranging the things for Mass. And the little girl, she had not yet received communion, but she was always helping the sisters, always in the church. And one day she was arranging the communion. She took one host and kissed it. And the sister looked at her and said, darling, this is not yet consecrated host. Jesus is not here. And she looked at the sister and said, you know, Jesus will come into this host tomorrow. And I want him to know I kissed him before he came into this host. I can't kiss him when he comes tomorrow. I have not yet received communion. But I want Jesus to know this host has been kissed. So what a saintly life this little girl lived. So the Eucharist is a real presence of Jesus. How many of you believe that Jesus is really going to come into you? Sure. Anybody doubting? It's the last chance to walk out of the church. Okay? If you doubt, you cannot receive Jesus. It's only thing. Nothing else is needed. Okay, put down your hand. So they are ready to receive Jesus because they know the real Jesus is coming into us. That's the difference between Protestants and us. Protestants believe in blessed bread. Blessed bread. It's blessed, that's all. Like you bless the rosary, you bless everything. But for us, it is a real body of Christ. So if you go to a Protestant church, there is no tabernacle. Where's the tabernacle here? Where? Okay, beautifully decorated tabernacle. That's where we keep Jesus, even after Mass. So you can come and talk to him. You can come and talk to him. So this is what is going to happen today. So first of all, it's a sacrament. Sacrament means, how many sacraments are there? What? Okay, somebody knew, was not answered. Anybody else? Those who come first to the mic, come fast. You're finished, no? Good. I'm glad you're coming again and again.
Baptism, confirmation, Holy Eucharist, confession, Holy Orders, matrimony.
penance.
Okay.
Baptism, confirmation, Holy Eucharist, penance, anointing the sick, holy orders, matrimony.
Very good. Congrats. Good. When people come to me for marriage preparation, they don't know the seven sacraments. One person I ask, how many sacraments are there? Sacraments. Nine? I said, who invented the extra two sacraments? Seven sacraments, important to know. Three sacraments to become a Christian. Baptism, confirmation, Holy Eucharist. How many? Baptism, Holy Eucharist. To become a full Christian. Second, two sacraments to heal us. Penance and anointing of the sick. And two sacraments of mission. Go out. Holy order and matrimony. Just as I am ordained a priest, you are married not to stay in your house. You are married to give Jesus to others. That's why it's a sacrament. Most of us are sitting at home cooking. No. It's give Jesus to others. That's why two sacraments of mission. Priesthood, married people. You're all missionaries of Jesus. Christ bearers, you're called to take Jesus to others. That's why the seven sacraments. God walks with us through the sacraments. What a beautiful God. From the time you're born till you're married, after that, till you're ready to die, Jesus walks with you. And to give us strength, the most important, which is the most important sacrament of all sacraments? Holy Eucharist. Good. Give him a hand. Come. Holy Eucharist. The most important sacrament, sacrament of all sacraments, because God Himself comes into us. What's the most important sacrament? Holy Eucharist, the summit of everything, the highest form of prayer. The highest form of prayer. There's nothing greater than the Eucharist, Rosary, all that. The highest form of prayer, because Jesus Himself breaks His body, gives it to us. Okay? So I'm going to tell you a few stories. And then we conclude today. The story of a few Eucharistic miracles, thousands of miracles that have taken place. I'm going to tell you today. Will you listen carefully? Okay. There's a story told of Sister Breege McKenna. It's come in the beautiful booklet by the Holy Spirit Interactive. The Sister Breege McKenna, she was in Latin America. Anybody knows where's Latin America? South America, okay? You've heard of Brazil, Chile, Argentina. Our present Pope is from South America, Latin America, Argentina, Pope Francis. What's the name of our Pope? Okay, so this lady was preaching in one of the slums of America, a favela, a slum. And the sister was there doing a healing work, healing the sick. And during the healing service, there is also the Eucharist as the highest point of healing. Most of the saints could heal because they came to the Eucharist without sin. If you come to the Eucharist without sin, you can work miracles. So this particular sister was getting involved in the Mass. There are a lot of people there. Big crowd, very poor place, not a church. They're having a Mass on the outside in the slum. And they put a little box at the altar. And the priest had started the Mass. It was a time of intercession, just before the consecration. A lady ran crying. She had a bundle of clothes, all wrapped up, dirty clothes all there. She kept it on the altar. And the sister looked at the priest. Can you keep on the altar? The priest said, fine, there's some problem here. Let it be on the altar. And all the people started praying, come Holy Spirit. Because before the Eucharist becomes the body of Christ, we pray to the Holy Spirit. We ask the Father, come Holy Spirit, make this host into the body of Christ. So everybody was praying, come Holy Spirit, come. And the sister went and opened this bundle of clothes. Inside she saw a baby. all burnt, completely burnt. And the mother was crying. So she had escaped from a fire and she brought the baby. And as soon as they saw that the baby was burnt, everybody started praying more and more, more and more. And then the mass continued, the consecration of the mass. They're all coming for communion. They looked at the baby was completely healed. There's new skin on the baby. And the mother took the baby in her arms and she said, Jesus is here. She said, Jesus is here. So all of you today, the word you have to use is Jesus is here. Jesus is. If you pray with faith during the Eucharist, if you made a good confession, you're completely pure, whatever you ask, if it is good for you, God will grant it to you, if it is good for you during the Eucharist. Because it's the highest form of prayer. There's nothing higher than the Eucharist. Understood? There's another story told of a priest who was taking communion. And he was taking communion by long time back, in the 1880s. They're going by horse. The priest was going by horse and he had to go very long distance into a remote village to take communion for a dying person. It was too late in the night. There was an inn. Inn means a kind of hotel. He said, let me stop here because very dangerous to continue, especially with the host. They can, steal the host. So he slept at night in one of those rooms. Early morning he got up, he had kept the pyx. The pyx is the small vessel in which you keep the consecrated host. He kept it in the drawer with the lighted candles, but in the night the candles went out. In the morning he rushed to take communion, but he forgot the pyx, the communion. He went away without the communion. Half the way he suddenly remembered, oh, I left the communion in that room. I hope, because he knew that the people of that hotel were disbelievers, they didn't believe in God. They were against the church. And he knew that if they found the host, they will desecrate it. So he took the horse and rushed back. And he came running to this. And he asked, sir, I'd like to go to that particular room. And the people of that hotel said, we have been searching for you. What happened in that room? We have been trying to open that room, but the room is not opening. And we see a big light coming from there. So they broke open the door. And then when the priest came, the door opened. And he knelt down, took the host, and he brought it back to the sick person. The power of Jesus in the host. I can tell you thousands of stories. No, not stories, real happenings. No, like Imelda, like this. How old are you? 8 years old. Imelda was more or less 7 years old. Imelda wanted to become a nun. But they said, you have to wait. Then she said, I want communion. And they said, you can't have communion till you're 12 years old. Imelda said, no, I want Jesus now. I want him now. Then what happened? You saw the story, no? You saw the video. Okay, so he went to the tabernacle. She started praying in front of the tabernacle.
After she prayed, the nun went outside the church. After receiving communion, then suddenly she saw a bright light. The nuns came inside, and the host was suspended. The nuns called the priest, and the priest fed the girl with the host.
Very good.
After soon as she received the host, she died. A saint.
Okay, very good. Since she remembers the story well, we showed them the video about Imelda. Since she did not get communion, she used to sit in front of the tabernacle. Pray, Jesus, I want you. But the priest will not give. She has to be 12 years old. And finally, one day, Jesus himself came through the form of the host and was hanging on the air. And the nuns called the priest, come, Father, something is happening. And the priest understands that Jesus himself wants to get into Imelda. So they give her communion. She smiles. She's in ecstasy. They all leave her alone. After some time, they want to take her home for breakfast. Early morning, They come very early into church, 5 o'clock, 4:30. Then they found that she was dead with a smile on her face. Jesus had come into it, was enough for her. So she is the patroness of all the first holy communicants. Saint? What's her name? Saint Imelda. She's not yet a saint, a blessed. Blessed Imelda. So let's remember, my dear friends, the real Jesus is going to come into them. The real Jesus. One of the things yesterday, very sad, sitting for confession, two or three children told me, I want to come to Mass, but my parents are not getting up in the morning. Don't lift up your hands. No, who said that? Not? Your parents are here. Huh? Don't lift up. But not one child, more than one child told me, my parents are sleeping, Father. How sad. Children want to come for Mass, you're not taking them for Mass. Very sad. So my dear parents, it's a wake-up call. The children are very frank. They're very open. If I come and sit, all your family problems will come out now. Huh? So the child told me that. So it's very sad. St. Dominic Savio, you know who St. Dominic Savio, no? Before he died very small, just 13 years old, when he received communion, he made a few vows. Any of you know the vows of Dominic Savio? Okay, I'll tell you, you'll remember now. I want Jesus, Mary and Joseph to be my friends. Who? Jesus, Mary and Joseph. Death rather than sin. What? Death rather than sin. Third, very important. I will go for Sunday Mass without fail. I will go for Sunday Mass without fail and make confession. He was a saint, but still he made confession. So let's repeat. Jesus, Mary and Joseph will be my friends. Second, rather than sin. Third, I will daily Mass and confess my sins. Very good. Who can tell me? Stand up and say. Okay, somebody else. Okay, you also said. Any new face? Okay. Last new face. Okay, come. With this, we wind up.
Jesus, Mary and Joseph as his friend. Death rather than sin. Then we attend the Sunday Masses without fail and confession. Mass without fail.
Okay, very good. Give her a hand. Yeah. So my dear friends, let's get ready now. It's the most sacred time now. Slowly we are moving towards a consecration. Remember all that I said. It's a real body of Christ. Real body of Christ. Jesus' body broken for us. So let us respect the church, and it also makes us communion. Anybody come, if you are baptized, if you are in good confession, anybody, even a mad person can receive communion. Even a mentally challenged person can receive communion, because Jesus loves. Jesus, that's why he comes. What's the last sentence of St. Matthew's Gospel? Behold, I am with you till the end of age. Very good. Behold, I am with you till the end of age. Which chapter? Which chapter? 28?
20. 28? 20. Dear Father Joe Andrew, we wish to present the following children who desire to receive Jesus into their hearts for the first time. Leanne, Catherine, Suan, Amelia, Kimberly, Erica, Daffodil, Jason, Charlotte, Lesria, Atalia, Maria Vinci, Linda, Jason, Agnes, Esther, DeAndre, Jocelyn, Lancy, Sandra Maria, Wendelin,
Priscilla, Natasha, Macarena, Margaret, Shereen, Steffi, Cynthia, Josephine, Charlene, Lou, Susan, Srividya, Rahel, Sylvester, Felix, Sebastian, Roger, Joshua Ignatius, Paul, Anthony Rowan, Samuel Jeremiah, Samuel Jason, Infanto, Benjamin, Leo, Isaac, Jaden, Sheldon, Leanne, Leonard.
It's beautiful to see them saying, "Here I am." Have they been well prepared? And are they aware of the privilege to which they're being called today?
They have been preparing themselves for the past 1.5 months with the help of teachers and priests. They have made their first confession. They are now eager to receive Jesus in the Eucharist. We request you, Father, to give them Holy Communion.
Dear children, I'm happy to welcome you to this Eucharistic table. You're young and you can be very generous like St. Dominic Savio. Let this day be dear to you. On the day of your baptism, you are made children of God. Today, Jesus will come into your hearts. He is the one who created you and he is the one who died for you. He loves you. Now I invite you to light your candles from the Paschal candle, which represents the light of Christ. Let keep this light always burning bright. The day we were baptized. Let's renew our baptismal vows. The day Jesus claimed us for his own, we became the children of God on our baptism day. So let us together with his children very loud and clear say, "Yes, I do." Do you reject Satan and all his works and all his empty promises? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth?
Yes, I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died and was buried, rose from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
Yes, I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who came upon the apostles at Pentecost? Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? Do you believe that you're going to receive Jesus Christ in the form of a simple piece of bread? This is our faith. This is the faith of our church. We are proud to profess it in Jesus Christ, our Lord. These children now come before you with their petitions. Our response would be, "Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer."
Lord Jesus, we are going to receive you into our hearts today for the first time. We pray that you will find in us a home worthy of you. Your response,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, you desire so much that we grow in mind and heart. Help each each of us to be responsible in our studies and in our behavior. Thus, may we become good citizens of heaven and earth. Your response?
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, we pray that you bless in a very special way our parents, brothers, sisters, and all those dear to us. They are doing so much to meet all our needs. Grant them the material and spiritual graces they stand in need of. Your response?
Lord Jesus, we are going to receive you in our hearts today for the first time. We pray that you would help us to become pure and holy, so that you will find in us a hope worthy of you. Your response? Lord Jesus, we pray that you bless abundantly all who have come here to pray for us, first communicants, and to share in our joy. Bless their families and work. Fill their lives with your love, peace, and joy. Your response?
Lord, hear our prayer. My dear friends, now the children will bring their first offering for the poor. They will bring their offering for the poor. This will be used for scholarship next year, whatever they offer. Two priests will come forward to receive their gifts.
Thank you. Father,
the Holy, Holy Church, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Together with the children, let us thank and praise God. It's a moment of thanksgiving, and the priest is saying this prayer. You'll also see on the screen, I think. You can also say, glory to God in the highest. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. God, our loving Father, we are glad to give you thanks and praise because you love us. With Jesus, we sing your praise. Because you love us, you gave us this great and beautiful world. With Jesus, we sing your praise. Because you love us, you sent Jesus, your Son, to bring us to you and to gather us around him as the children of one family. With Jesus, we sing your praise. For such great love, we thank you with all the angels and saints as they praise you and sing. Jesus is wanting to come to us. So let us feel happy that Jesus is here. Blessed be Jesus, whom you sent to be the friend of children and of the poor. He came to show us how we can love you, Father, by loving one another. He came to take away sin, which keeps us from being friends, and hate, which makes us all unhappy. He promised to send the Holy Spirit to be with us always, so that we can live as your children. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. God our Father, we now ask you to send your Holy Spirit to change these gifts of bread and wine into the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord. The night before he died, Jesus your Son showed us how much you love us. When he was at supper with his disciples, he took bread and gave you thanks and praise. Then he broke the bread, gave it to his friends and said, take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. Then he said to them, do this in memory of me. Take this. Then when supper was ended, Jesus took the cup, it was filled with wine. He thanked you, gave it to his friends and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." And so, loving Father, we remember that Jesus died and rose again to save the world. He put himself into our hands to be the sacrifice we offer you. We shall say together, "We praise you, we bless you, we thank you." Say together, "We praise you, we bless you, we thank you." Lord our God, listen to our prayers. Send the Holy Spirit to all of us who share in this meal. May the Spirit bring us closer together in the family of the Church, with Francis our Pope, George Antony Sami our Bishop, all of the bishops, priests, religious, and all who serve your people. Let's say together, "We praise you, we bless you, we thank you." Remember, Father, our families and friends. All the children, pray for your parents now. Your parents, your teachers, all those who prepared you for communion. All the parents, pray for your children, that they may really receive Jesus and live for him. Let's also pray for our friends and dear ones. Let's now remember all who have died in our families. Remember those who have died, bring them home to be with you forever. Let's say together, "We praise you, we bless you, we thank you." Gather us all together into your kingdom, that we shall be happy forever with the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and our Mother, that all the friends of Jesus the Lord will sing a song of joy. Let's say it together, "We praise you, we bless you." Now we offer the body and blood of Jesus to our Father in heaven. When you sing Amen, all of you offer yourselves to the Father.
Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Thank you. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
On this beautiful day, when our children are going to receive communion, let us forgive one another. If you have to forgive somebody in your heart, forgive them now. And let us feel the peace of Christ. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
you, Jesus. Jesus, please continue to live in my heart.
Give a big hand to Jesus who has come to all of us and say thank you, Jesus. Our children may not have fully understood, but slowly the parents will give them this, the milk of faith. What is the meaning of the Eucharist? Little by little, I see so many parents, they spend so much of time with the Eucharistic Lord. So give the same faith to your children, so that they may enjoy the Eucharistic Jesus. So thank all the parents in a special way for having brought your children for this 45 days of special class for Holy Communion. So let's give all your parents a good clap and say thank you, parents. I'd like to thank all the priests who are here, friends, relatives of all the children, and Father Vincent also is joining us today. So let's give them a big hand and say thank you, fathers. I'd like to thank the three teachers who are with them for 45 days, besides the Sunday catechism, that is separate. It is 45 days every evening without fail. They were here together with these children. So to our three teachers, let's say a big word of thank you. Let's all give them a big hand. So I request Mrs. Susan and Mary Jones and Mrs. Stella to come forward. Father Vincent will give them a memento and can go in front. So let's clap hard. We're all very lazy. So thank you, Mary Jones, thank you, Susan, for the hard work. Let's give them a big hand. And thank you, Mrs. Stella, for the hard work put in. Let's give a hand. I thank Mr. John Sebastian for working with his team whole night to put up all these decorations. So thanks, John, for almost single-handedly doing this. I'd like to thank the flower, not the flower girls, those arranged these beautiful flowers day in and day night. Sisters and lay people involved. So I'd like to thank them in a very, very special way. So let's give a big hand to all the people who beautifully decorate the flowers. And I'd like to thank in a special way the choir today, the children's choir. They sang very beautifully. And together with them, Let's give them a nice hand and say thank you. I thank Orlando, Darren and Eugene for being with these small children and making them excited in singing. I'm sure this children's group will join and become big. So all of you can also join the choir slowly. Okay, those of you who can sing. Those of you are bathroom singers, sing at home. Those of you are good at singing, join the choir. And 11th of this month, all of you can join with your white dress. 11th evening mass, all of you can join for Our Lady's mass with your white dress. So you have another opportunity to wear your dress. After some time, if you're not using the dress, give it to some poor people who can use it. Okay? And next feast, next year, February, we'll be using the dress again. So keep it safely. After that, you can give it away. 8th September, Feast of Our Blessed Mother. And we'll have a special mass in the evening. 11th, every 11th is special in our parish. The 11 o'clock mass and the evening mass. So invite all the First Holy Communion children to come and celebrate the birthday of Our Blessed Mother. In our parish, we'll celebrate on the 11th, since many will be going to Velankanni. September 12th, we have a special Reconciliation Day every second Saturday. And these are the main things to keep in mind. On 13th Sunday, we'll have the raffle, St. Anthony's Church raffle draw. You can come with your tickets on that day. We thank St. Cecilia Zone, our sponsor, the stained glass window. Other zones are welcome to do the same. So I thank the altar service, the photographers, Mr. Nambi, Mr. Sundar Prasad, and all the other volunteers and all the others. So thank you. God bless for all the work you are doing. Let's give them a hand and say thank you. So all of you just close your eyes for a minute. There's been a lot of distraction even during communion. When you have so many photographers, we always have this problem. So just thank Jesus personally, each one of you. Close your eyes, everyone. Close your eyes and say your personal prayer to Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for coming into my heart. I adore you, Jesus. I love you, Jesus. Let's sing all together, Into My Heart, Come Into My Heart, together with the children especially. As you sing this song, ask Jesus to stay with you always. So the Holy Communion children, you can stand up, sing with the choir, Into My Heart. Because Jesus is already into your heart, but ask Him to stay with you forever. From this day onwards, Jesus must stay with you, guide you and protect you. Thank you. Loving Jesus, we thank you for coming into our children today. You have humbled yourself to become an insignificant piece of little bread. So precious. We thank you, Lord, this morning for coming to our hearts. You mingle with our body. Your body and blood become a part of our own body and blood. And through this you give us salvation without our knowledge. You told us many times when you spoke to the people. We hear it in the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6, I am the bread of life. He who eats my bread will have no other hunger, will have no other thirst. Fill our hunger and our thirst with your body and blood, that all of us may become good bread for others. All the parents may break themselves for their families, for their children, for society, that we may build up a good society of love, peace and joy, that your kingdom may come through the Eucharist. May the Eucharist unite us, the rich and the poor, the different people of various languages. May all of us be united, the weak and the strong. May all of us be united by the power of the Eucharist. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. So bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Lord, grant your children your protection and grace, give them health of mind and body, perfect love for one another, and make them always faithful to you. Amen. We conclude with a novena prayer to Our Lady of Lourdes. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone could reflect your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession, was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy hear and answer me. Amen. Our Lady of Lourdes, Mother of God. Our Lady of Lourdes, Mother of the Church. Our Lady of Lourdes assumed into heaven. Our Lady of Lourdes Immaculate Conception. Our Lady of Lourdes did the will of God. Our Lady of Lourdes Refuge of Sinners. Our Lady of Lourdes Health of the Sick. Our Lady of Lourdes Help of Christians. Our Lady of Lourdes Mother of Youth and Children. Our Lady of Lourdes Mother of the Poor and Abandoned. Our Lady of Lourdes Mother of Priests and Religious. God our Father, we thank you for giving us Mary as our mother and the mother of the Church. Through her apparitions at Lourdes, she taught the world to follow her Son, Jesus, more closely. May her prayers deepen in us the spirit of love for the Lord and for our neighbor. Bring us health of mind and body in this world and win for us everlasting life. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. The Almighty God bless and protect you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go to love and serve one another. Thank you. A kind request, please respect the church. After the Mass, you can take your children out. Take as many photos as you want. But try not to shout inside the church, make noise here. Let us all together with the children sing the final hymn.
Dear parents and children, it's the right time to thank our Father, Father Joe Andrew, Rector and Parish Priest, for everything, for the love, for the care, and for the spiritual animation. Let's give him thanks. Let's simply clap and say a big thanks to him for animating, for loving us, and for caring us. So much of love that he gives us for the church, for Perambur, Lushan. Also, let's not forget, let's keep him in our prayers. Let's pray very deep to the Holy Spirit, that God may bless our Father, dear Father, Father Joe Andrew.
கிறிஸ்து இயேசுவில் பிரியமானவர்களே, நமது அற்புத இயேசு டிவியில் ஒளிபரப்பாகும் எழுச்சியூட்டும் இறை செய்திகள், அபிஷேக ஆராதனைகள் மற்றும் நிகழ்ச்சிகள் மூலம் எண்ணற்ற மக்கள் மன மாற்றத்தையும் உடல் சுகத்தையும் ஆழ்ந்த இறை அனுபவத்தையும் பெற்று வருகிறீர்கள் என்பதை அறிந்து நாங்கள் ஆண்டவருக்கு நன்றி செலுத்துகிறோம். ஆண்டவருடைய நாமம் மகிமைப்படுவதாக. பிரியமானவர்களே, இந்த உன்னதமான நற்செய்தி பணியின் எல்லைகள் விரிவுபடுத்தப்படவும் இன்னும் நம்முடைய சகோதர சகோதரிகள் திரள் திரளாக ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவின் அன்பை அறிந்து கொள்ளவும் இந்த பணி எந்த தடையுமின்றி தொடர்ந்து நடக்கவும் தேவைகள் சந்திக்கப்படவும் உங்கள் ஜெபங்களையும் தாராளமான காணிக்கைகளையும் அன்புடன் எதிர்பார்க்கிறோம். நீங்கள் காணிக்கைகளை அனுப்ப வேண்டிய விவரங்கள், பேங்க் டீடைல்ஸ்,
பேங்க் ஆஃப் இந்தியா, அக்கௌண்ட் நேம் ஜீசஸ் ஹெல்ப்ஸ், அக்கௌண்ட் நம்பர் 8033101956, பேங்க் நேம் பேங்க் ஆஃப் இந்தியா, பேங்க் பிரான்ச் வாஷர்மேன் பெட்,
ஸ்டேட் பேங்க் ஆஃப் இந்தியா, அக்கௌண்ட் நேம் நெல்சன் ஆண்டனி எல், பேங்க் நேம் ஸ்டேட் பேங்க் ஆஃப் இந்தியா, அக்கௌண்ட் நம்பர் 3007875656565, ஐஎஃப்எஸ்சி கோட் எஸ்பிஐ என் 0001794, பிரான்ச் நியூ வாஷர்மன் பெட்.
அட்ரஸ் ஃபார் மணி ஆர்டர், டிடி அண்ட் செக், அற்புதர் ஏசு டிவி, 56/11, ஆவூர் முத்தையா ஸ்ட்ரீட், நியூ வாஷர்மன் பெட், சென்னை 81.
காண்டாக்ட் நம்பர்ஸ் 8148912933,
9789866627
and 9790721603. Email ID nelsonajokiam@gmail.com. ஆண்டவர் உங்களை ஆசீர்வதிப்பாராக.